Waxy Wonders is a vendor wax company. Jennifer is the owner of it, and she's probably the hardest working woman I've ever seen. She has a ton of restocks, always a ton of inventory. She takes requests, and this haul was for chunk mystery bags. She just finished a round, or is in the process of finishing a round of custom wax for people, and she does them in chunks. There's like three, I think, or four in every custom bag, so she takes the overflow of those and made these mystery bags. Each bag is 2.5 pounds. Sorry, I'm looking to the side, the invoice is there. And that's 10 bags. I got two of the bakery. They also had like fresh, fruity, things like that. I just got bakery because I've been buying all bakery lately because I was really, really low. That is not a problem anymore. So each one was $27. Like I said, I got two, so that was $54 with shipping. Was $66.45. It got here super fast. So I'm gonna go through the ones I liked first, and then the ones that are really like in my scent wheelhouse at the end. So I'm just gonna grab from this giant box full of chunks that I have, and let's start here. So the first is Pretzel Don't Cross Streams. This is Pretzel and Don't Cross Streams is a like a vanilla bakery blend that she uses. It's really good. And this is really good. I'm not a crazy pretzel person, but I think there's enough of the Don't Cross Streams. You can kind of see. It's an interesting color combination, huh? I think there's enough of the Don't Cross Streams that I can pull it off. This is sort of like an outside of my comfort zone, but still pretty good chunk. So that's Pretzel Don't Cross Streams. This is just a straight lemon pound cake, which sometimes when you stick your whole nose in the bag, it's good. You don't get the bakery on cold, but I would assume it will probably come out when I warm it. Also, sorry for my lack of makeup, but it's the weekend. Yeah, it's good. It smells very lemony. I don't get a lot of bakery yet, but I'm, like I said, I'm sure once it cures and I warm it up, I'll be able to smell it. This is strawberry bread, strawberry sugar, and mallow fluff. I am not a crazy strawberry person. I think everybody is just really particular about the kind of strawberries that they like. And so I think this is good. I think the strawberry bread is what is in it that I'm selling that I really like. That bready note. Also, I should say, if any of these are yours, feel free, and like any of these blends belong to you or you're the one who made them, feel free to say so in the comments. And if I don't like one that you made, it's not you. It's just my scent preference, you know. I'm sure everyone likes these because they ordered them, so yeah. It's sweet and slightly bready with a little bit of an artificial strawberry, but it's still really good, and I think it'll be, the bread will come out on warm because I can already smell it. This is Fat Bottom Girls and Strawberry Pound Cake. I don't have the notes for Fat Bottom Girls, but it's a bakery blend that is sort of like a house blend from L3. Once again, the strawberry smells, it's real pretty. It looks like watermelon colors. I don't know if it comes through on the camera. It smells like strawberry, like candied strawberry kind of. With a bakery behind it. I think when it's warmed up, the bakery is going to come out even more, so I'm actually really excited about that one. I think it'll be good. This is Palo Santo Don't Cross Streams, which is that vanilla bakery blend of Palo Santo. I'm pretty sure I will really like this because she has a very popular scent called Today is October 3rd, which is Don't Cross Streams, Palo Santo, and I think Toasted Mallow. And I love that. I have it in a scoopable. It's super popular. It sells out super fast. She actually just had a restock today, and she had it in little tiny loaves, and she calls them bitty bitty loaves, and it sold out right away. This is really good. It's like that sweet vanilla bakery with the Palo Santo. Her Palo Santo is really nice as a mixer. It doesn't, it's there, but it doesn't like take everything over. If you've never smelled Palo Santo before, it's like an earthy, manly smell, but it's like chill enough that you can mix it with a bakery and it actually works really well. I know it doesn't sound like it would, but it does. This is, I was really excited about this one. This is Pink Frosted Animal Cookies. Today is October 3rd. So like I said, today is October 3rd. It's that Palo Santo Toasted Mallow Vanilla Bakery blend. And then Pink Frosted Animal Cookies. On cold, I can smell today is October 3rd. I can smell the Palo Santo. And you can tell, like, there's another bakery in there, so I'm really excited to warm this. It's really, really pretty. Really pretty color. So whoever made that, well done. Well done to everyone. I also ordered, like, a lot of custom bags. So that will be coming soon. I'll get that in a minute. This is Diet Starts Monday. This is actually one that I've been wanting to try. It's cotton candy frosting, sugar cookie royale, Santa's on keto sugared shortbread. So this is just like a bakery sweet cotton candy delicious mix. I can definitely smell the cotton candy, and I think that shortbread is also coming out. I think this is gonna totally like come alive when you warm it though. And I'm gonna let all these cure because she's obviously just started pouring all of these because they're customs. So I'm gonna give them all about 2 weeks. This is today is October 3rd and vanilla butter fudge. Can you tell that today is October 3rd is really popular? I should have, like, I didn't know how much I liked today is October 3rd until after I did customs, because customs were like maybe the first order or the second order I ever did with her, and so I would have probably just gotten two giant chunk bags of today is October 3rd if I would have known how much I liked it. Oh, this smells so good. The vanilla butter fudge just gives more depth to the bakery, and it works really well with the Palo Santo. I would highly recommend this. It's today is October 3rd and vanilla butter fudge. Highly, highly recommend this blend. I will definitely remember that. And I'm pretty sure that's gonna be one of my favorites. This is White Elephant Exchange Jet Puff Mallow. So White Elephant Exchange is her other really popular bakery. There's like three or four of them. And it's like donut holes and vanilla wafers. It's just like vanilla bakery amazingness. And then Jet Puff Mallow is a marshmallow smell. It's very light on cold, and I'm sure I will like it. It just like is kind of vanilla-y and light on cold though, so I think it's one of those things that I'm gonna have to warm to know if I like love it or not. I'm excited to try that one. This is an interesting one. It's like a little bit outside of my comfort zone, but I'm excited to try it. So this is Enchanted Pears. Pears and a creamy, wonderful bakery scent. The pear is not nice. I mean, you know, I think anytime you try and duplicate a fruit in a fragrance oil, if it's intense, it can smell kind of candied. So this does have like a very sweet candied pear, but it's really nice and refreshing. And I think in the summer, if you want a bakery but you don't want it to be cloying or heavy, something like this could be really nice. because that fruit lightens it up and kind of is a good juxtaposition to the bakery. So that is Enchanted Pears. Yeah,
it's a lot of tote bags. Okay, three more of the ones I like, and then we'll go through the ones I don't and the samples.
So this is just coffee bean whipped cream. I am not a crazy coffee person. And Wax, this is really pretty though, right? But this is good coffee. It's like a very pure coffee, but it's not bitter. And like, it's not like a mocha or, you know, it's just like a nice coffee with that sweetness from the whipped cream. I think it's going to be really good, and I think it would be really nice as a mixer too, so that was really good.
Whoever made that, congratulations.
This is Stay Puft. I looked at the scent notes on this when I got it. Look how pretty the colors are. That's a teal. I don't know if you can see it through the camera. This is Adipose. Adipose, I'm probably saying it wrong. Which is like a sweet scent. I think it has a touch of cherry in it and a marshmallow. And it's just like a really sweet, nice scent. I think it'd be a good mixer. I'm hoping the cherry doesn't come out too much on warm, but we'll see. And then the last one from the light pile, and then I'll go through the samples, is Strawberry Pound Cake Sugar Cookie Royale Cupcakes at Tiffany's Palo Santo. Wow, that's a hell of a mix. So once again, you can see everyone likes her Palo Santo. This is surprisingly really good. And I just say surprisingly because there's just like a ton going on here, right? Like Strawberry Pound Cake, Sugar Cookie Royale, Cupcakes at Tiffany's, and that Palo Santo. But that Palo Santo really, it gives it life. Like, it keeps it from being way too sweet, like way too just like sweet, sweet, sweet on top of each other. It smells really good. I'm actually really excited to warm that one. So those are the stars of it. Let's do samples really quickly, and then we'll go on to some of, I'll be probably either be selling or giving away in like a random act of kindness. She gave me a sample of Dr. Finkelstein's Assistant. It's like a little cup. I don't think it's a scoopable. Oh, it is a scoopable. I didn't look up the scent notes for this. It smells orange. I don't love it. I usually, you know what? I don't often melt samples because I don't think you can, like, get a good sense of them. But I have now a new warmer in my office, which I'm sitting in, and so, I might melt through more samples instead of just giving them away. This is Cupcakes at Tiffany Zucchini Bread. This is okay. I'm not like a crazy zucchini bread person. Like, I can do it mixed with other things in if it's mixed really well. But I'll probably end up giving this away or throwing it in like a random act of kindness or something like that. This one was the star of the show. Cashmere Cedar Wildflower Honey Palo Santo. Seriously? Oh my god, this smells so good. This would be such a nice summer scent. It has a light sweet floral and that earthiness from the Palo Santo, but the cashmere cedar gives it like a little bit more depth and like makes it smell a little bit more fancy, for lack of a better term. This is gonna be really good, and I probably will, if she ever offers that in a larger quantity, I will probably pick some up and pack some everywhere. Okay, let's talk a little bit about the ones that I got that were not my style. Let's just say that. So, and once again, if you made these blends, more power to you. This is no shit to anybody's blends. I'm terrible at blending. I just did like house blends when I was buying my custom. So it's just my personal preference. It's what I like. Smell is very personal. So the first one is Blue Raspberry Cotton Candy Hot Buttered Popcorn Funnel Cake. And it's the popcorn. I don't even really like the smell of popcorn like when I make it in my house.
This is hummingbird cake. It's banana nut bread, pineapple, cinnamon sugar. I don't like pineapple in wax. It's just a preference. Like, I've just never really... You know, I probably could get down with this, to be honest. The cinnamon sugar is kind of what's saving it. But if someone likes pineapple, they would probably like this a ton more. Because that is kind of what, like, throws me off a little bit. Like, I like banana nut bread and I like cinnamon sugar, but I don't love pineapple. And when you don't love something, it's just, like, the first thing you smell. That's just the way that it works. So I'll give this to someone or sell it or, you know, whatever, to someone who will appreciate it and who likes pineapple and all those other things. But it's really good. It's strong. As all scents are that you don't like, right? This is Radiant Red Maple, which is a Bath & Body Works candle scent type. I've never had that candle, but I looked it up. I don't like this. It actually has this note in it. It's just green and light green. So if you ever smelled Scentsy Apple S'mores, it's like a very polarizing scent. People love it or they hate it. And I don't like it. It has this overly sweet apple note in it that is like sort of, this like, it kind of smells like when apples go bad, in my opinion. If you love it, you love it. That's great. I like shit people don't like either. It has that note and it's just like, I can't do it. So that's gonna go to somebody who likes that scent, which a lot of people do, obviously, because they make a scent oil and use it in other places. Okay. This is Mac Apple Honey Buttered Rolls Cornbread. Oh, there's a lot in here for me. I don't mind apple, although Mac Apple is my least favorite type of apple in fragrance wax. I like more like Red Delicious or Green Apple. Honey Buttered Rolls. Okay, hear me out. On cold, you mostly just get the apple and maybe like a touch of the rolls, but I don't like cornbread, and I'm pretty damn sure when I warm this up, that's all I'm gonna smell. And a lot of people really like cornbread. There's another vendor, Super Tarts. They have a Freddy Krueger, I don't know what it's called now, but wax melt that has cornbread in it, and I had to stop melting it because all I could smell was the cornbread, and it just smells like Fritos to me. I'm just not into it, so I'm gonna give that one away to somebody who would like all those notes. This is another popcorn one. This is Fenway Park, which is salted peanuts, popcorn, caramel apple, and a hint of cotton candy. It's not as bad as the other one. It's like blue with light yellow chunks in it. Oop, little piece fell off. It's not as bad as the other one. I think all those notes kind of chill it out a little bit. But there's also nothing about it that I'm just, like, in love with. And I don't melt wax I don't like. It's just, life's too short, right? And I have enough wax. So I will either sell that or give that away to someone who will like it. Okay, two more in the not like column. So this is Godiva White Chocolate Raspberry Truffles Cheesecake. Okay, so this all sounds good. Like, I would eat all of that in a minute. But the Godiva white chocolate and the raspberry truffles, I think it's the raspberry. The raspberry is kind of off-putting. It's, like, very sweet and artificial because it's in chocolate, you know? Like, it's supposed to be not, like, a fresh raspberry, but, like, a raspberry truffle. Which I think it's very accurate, but it just, like, doesn't float my boat. I think a lot of people would really like that, actually. If you like raspberry and you like sweet scents, you might really be into that. So, that'll go to a good home. And the last one I was not a huge fan of is Hot Orange Danish. I'm not a crazy orange bakery fan. It smells good. It just smells like orange. I can't. I don't really smell like any. Everything's falling. I don't really smell like any bakery in it. I'm sure it will come out when it's warmed. If I'm gonna smell orange, I like it usually like in a clean scent or like a fresh scent. I just prefer it like that. So I'll make sure that that goes to a good home or put it in a destash group or something like that. I usually just like set all the wax that I don't really, that I'm not really into aside and then decide where it goes. Yeah, so overall, each of these was 10 bags and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 of the 20 I didn't like. So that was a pretty good average. I'm kind of picky, so I'm really happy with it. I don't often buy things like mystery bags or samplers because, for that reason, I don't like just not liking things and then having them go to waste, or and I don't melt things I don't like. But I think this was really cool. It was really neat to just like experience the stuff that she has because she has so much. So yeah, I'm gonna wrap up here. She does have a restock that just went live today, so you should jump on her site. She always has lots of stuff left over if you want to try it out. And I have two other hauls to film, so I'll film those.